Well, good evening and welcome to the session on pure functional programming on JVM with Frege. My name is Naresha and I work for a company called ChannelBridge. Frege, you can call it as, there are two ways to look at it. One as Haskell on JVM. Another one is somebody who is, working on the JVM and want a tool or a platform where you can do pure functional programming. Then what capability do you have, or what are the options available? So I'm mostly presenting from the second point of view because that's my background, especially because if you're already a Haskell programmer, then you'd have certain existing code, so you want all those code exactly to be run on JVM, etc. Whereas you wouldn't have that constraint if you're on JVM and you want a better tool for functional programming. Before I get started, I just want to get a feel of how many are actually already programming in Clojure, Haskell, anything of that sort. That's a good part of it. How many are mostly new to functional programming or program in functional style? Well, a mix of that. Well, so interestingly, the reason how I got led to this is can we do functional programming or with discipline, essentially something like immutability versus when it is enforced by the platform. Some of the typical perceived benefits like ability to change, keep on changing the variable. When you sacrifice that, obviously you are forced to think in a different direction, and you get a lot of benefits for your programming. So with that effort, as a platform for platform in the sense a tool on JVM for programming in pure functional way, got discovered Frege, which is interestingly, initially it got started as if I use the Wayback Machine, June 1st, 2014, it says it's a programming language in the spirit of Haskell. But if you today, it's mostly Frege is Haskell for JVM. That's a kind of evolution it went through. With that, I'll straight away get started. So let me start with a simple program first. Let's get started. Say functional conf dot hello. Sorry. So this is my directory structure. Right now I just have a hello and a lib. So I'm going to compile my free program. Sorry. And let me run that. Let me show the structure before. So I created my program in hello.fr, and when I compile essentially, which will call you know, there is no Frege C as such executable available, but it's calling Java program, which Java in turn, which we will use the Frege library, which will internally call the Java compiler to translate this. So what you see is that a file called hello.java got created, and which then got compiled into hello.class, and then I ran hello.class from. So that essentially, that's the structure. So if you just want to take a look at how does it work. So that's the, you know, generated Java code, which then gets compiled into bytecode. So essentially, the way Frege works is unlike many of the languages on JVM. First, it compiles into Java source code. Then it, you know, using the typical Java compiler, it gets compiled into bytecode, and from there you run it. That's how it's going. It comes with the REPL. There are quite a few options for the REPL. So we have the, you know, REPL which you can you know, download from the Frege you know, GitHub page, and you can use that. That's one option. See. You also get Java effects REPL. So if you want, you can use that. Also, there is online REPL available at try.fregelang.org. So you can use any of these options. So for most of my talk, I'll stick to the REPL what I have, which is simple, I believe. So, any questions? So essentially, I mean, if you look at the Java code, it has a lot of, it can have other classes also there. So, a lot of things are created by Frege itself. So, your class files would represent that structure itself. Right. So if you look at the structure, so in my file I gave fc.hello, so under my build you'd see fc got created directory, and hello.class, so the last part will be converted to your you know, the class file will be named the last part, previous will be your package structure as usual. Okay, so let's get into REPL, and let me create a function. Say add a. So you would see Frege is a, you know, statically compiled language. I mean, since it's an implementation of Scala, that would be obvious. But for somebody who is coming from any other Java or any other dynamic languages on Java background, so it's a statically typed, and it's the type. You don't have to specify the type. You know. The compiler can infer the type here, so you would see it inferred it as a number. So let me just call, say, 1020. That's going to work, and say, so that's essentially going to work for any of those things. Having said that, if you want to specify the type, you always have the option to specify that. Say, I say add int, right? So I can say it's from int to int. Sorry, int to int. So I can say
Sure.
Yeah, now it's going to give a compilation error because it has to be an integer. So you have the option to specify it, or a compiler can infer that. So next, one of the very important part for somebody who is coming from any other functional style language could be about the purity. So let me just create one more file. Let me create the same maybe add A plus B. Then I'll create one more function. Here I would say I would call from mail. Which one? Oh, thank you. So let me So by default, I mean, it will not allow you to introduce side effects in your code. So if you want, you have to enforce it, be explicit about that you want your function to have side effects. So you can go into this. Yeah, now it is compiled, so I can run. So by default, functions cannot introduce side effects, so which will give you additional advantage to make sure things are immutable. Now let's get back to the REPL. So we have already wrote the function add, you can call something like this. And interestingly, if you call the function just with the one argument instead of multiple one, it's going to create a function. I mean, it's a partial application of function. So where you just specify your single argument, it's going to create another function. So I can just add 10. Now I say add 10 and say 20. That's going to do that. So by default, even when I wrote add 10, 20, so first it's going to apply add on 10. So right, as a result, you will get a function which will be then applied to 20. So function application will have a higher precedence. So if you want to change it, you will have to explicitly you can use parentheses. For example, say now I want to add this to one more, right? Add one more 10. So instead of, you would want to say add 10 and you're going to get that result. Or there's another way to, if you go on doing this, the code will not look very good. So instead of that, you can be, use a dollar. You're going to get the same result, wherein you don't have to really specify that parenthesis. Any questions? Things are clear. Yeah. They have implemented the whole, JVM by default doesn't have a way to lazy execute and all those things. They have implemented it in Java. Then again, they have implemented Prelude in the language in Frege itself. That's how they work. Yes, it is lazy. There's a basic implementation of the language in Java. The libraries are implemented in the language, for instance. Yeah, mostly. They implement Haskell 2010 report, but it may not be 100% compatible with GHC as of now. So if you go to the GitHub, there's a page where they list, these are the differences, especially for Haskell programmers. Yeah. Okay, so let's get into function of composition. Maybe let's make another function. So I can call increment 10, it'll give 11. So now, say I want to increment twice, right? Increment of increment. So if you want to create a function by composing two functions, in this case, I can just use the same function twice. This is going to give me another function now. 2, 10, that will give me 12. So you can take two functions compose to get another function which you can then apply. That's how you would do composition. So we have seen currying. So interestingly, the name Frege, it's named after a German mathematician called Gottlob Frege, who was the first one to propose currying concepts. So it's named after it. Well, so let's get into working with the lists, which will also explore a bit of laziness, and we would see laziness in bit detail also. So now say you can always give the complete numbers like this, specify list 1 2 3 4, or say I just want, can now specify a range. And you also have the option of having infinite lists. So right now, say let me just say I want to take 10 from these. That's going to give me 10. So if I don't use it, nothing will be evaluated. So lists are lazy. Similarly, you can specify, say, so if you just want given numbers, first 10, you do this way. I'm not very sure what is the implementation there. Whole language is lazy. So again, I mean, as the function previously we have seen any of those functions. So let me just do this, say Java. That will give me the Java code. I can just search there. So let me. So you would see final lazy being used. So to implement that, essentially some of these are some of the structures they use. So you would see there's a lazy interface. So most of them are gets smaller. So you would see the same, you know, if you should see the method signatures, it would have all of them. So it would not be a, you know, your regular int or, you know, anything of that sort. So that's because it has to be lazy. Okay, so let's just combine some of these principles, and let's do the famous fizzbuzz in a smaller way. So, I mean, I hope you know every third word will be fizz, and every fifth word will be buzz, and wherever you know they combine, you will have fizzbuzz. That's how the pattern. Again, so we can start with the fizz, and it will be of the pattern nothing with empty fizz. So I can generate you know that pattern, make it infinite by saying cycle. Similarly, buzz I can create, say, buzz. So still nothing has happened. So now I want to create a fizz buzz. So I can do, say, combine these two together with the zip. What I want to do is concatenate those two into one, and so that will give me another list. So now I want to say so you'd see the third one is fizz, fifth one is buzz, and 15th one is fizz buzz. So next level would be, you know, putting a number instead of empty. So essentially we have a combined you know list things together here. Okay, so having since Frege is running on JVM, an important aspect for the language is to interoperate with the Java language. So if you have a Java library, how do we use it from Frege and the other way also? So let's explore an example on that. So let me create Java class. Let's say increment. That's a very simple class, function increment, which we want to use from Frege. So let me go here. Java C. Now you would see the helper class is available. So let me write the free code. So essentially, say I want to create, increment, and increment. So I just want to use that assets. So here I'll have to define that Java function or the signature. That's I want to call it as increment itself, which is coming from helper.incr. Takes an integer and returns an integer. So since you know, the function doesn't have any side effects, let me put it as pure. Awesome, thank you. So it's calling that. So let's assume the exactly. I'm coming into that. So let's I mean, instead of writing another function, let's assume that it's having a side effect. So I am not giving it as pure. So now I'll go back and try to compile that. So it's you know, not allowing to do that because it's a IO unit, right? So if you're integrating with Java, there is no magic way to figure out if the function is pure or not. So it's up to the developer to specify that I'm writing a pure function or not writing the pure function, and it will rest of the system will go with that, whatever you have specified. Increment has illegal return. Yeah, that's error E. No, it is here, right? INC. It's directly assigned. So, I mean, if I have to use it, I have to use it in a context where it's right with Dune. That yeah, that seems like a good idea. I'm not sure. I'm not heard of any implementation of that such. I believe from the effort wise, that would be more or less same. I mean, you have to specify it somewhere whether this is pure or not. Yeah. Well, interesting. I haven't tried it out. I think some. I'm not sure what is the exact type for that. But essentially, if it doesn't return, I mean, it can be an you know, I mean, IO unit. It can't be a pure function. So, right, yeah. That's some IO unit, right? Any other questions? Yeah. So this is about you know, using Java functions or Java code in from your free programs. The other way is also possible, but still a lot of work is going on. So if you look at the, so there are two versions of you know, calling free code from Java. You would see from 3.24 onwards they have something new, and otherwise. So essentially it will not be very straightforward. You should be aware of some implementation, typically they call it as a Frege runtime system. So these type systems you need to be aware, so that you know, instead of passing simple types, you'd have to use wrap them in lazy and all these kind of implementations. But yeah, so with that effort, it would be possible. So mostly, if your Frege implementation, I mean whatever code you have written in Frege, if you want to use it, typically would require some sort of you know, wrapper being written, if that is going to be extensively used. So yeah, I think that would be the approach for doing that. Any questions? Yeah, so I was talking about the differences. Yeah, so here you have the differences between Frege and Haskell. So which is mainly for people who are coming from the Haskell background. Kind of, let me show that. This is what yeah, you will have to use you know, Gradle or something like that, which will do this. Yeah. So this will you know, spit out create Java files and then the class files, then finally you can create a jar out of it, which can be, you know, done through Gradle. So essentially, you know, what I'm using, you know, is, I mean, this is the jar file. So along with this jar file, whatever jar file you have created, if you can put that, that'll work. So essentially from Java, you're accessing these things. Or at least Tomcat would have the bootstrapping code. That's how it works by default. So the whole the approach they have taken is your Frege code gets converted into Java code, which you can it is possible, but it would require some sort of boilerplate code as of now, I believe, because you will have to, you know, adapt those into Frege type systems. Yeah. Yes, it's a jar. Since it gets converted into Java, there should be binary compile. Yes, because interop is at the Java level, right? Well, some function signatures got changed or something like that. Right, but Scala doesn't go that way. So since this is going through Java, so that has to be maintained. I mean, unless you change the, you know, the whole library definition itself. Okay. Different versions of Java, or then you would have the new jar I mean, mostly if you have a jar, that should be pretty much compatible. I don't see any issue why. Because Java version has changed, it will not become incompatible. Rather. But if Frege version has changed and you are writing new code, then yeah, obviously you have. I mean, unless there is some breaking changes also. So. This REPL, what you saw, this is written in Frege itself with some JavaScript front end. So sometimes in case of errors, you may get some jQuery errors and also. I'm not aware of a company who has, I don't think anybody has admitted we are using Frege for these things. But I believe, the way to go would be to start small, since it integrates well with Java, that would be a approach before going for a full-fledged. Yeah, so I mean, in this, it's essentially immutable, so you can pass the same structure to any number of threads. That will not be a problem. I'm not sure of that. No, Haskell is just a thin layer on Java. I mean, sorry, not Haskell, I'm free. You can use Java. I'm not sure if Haskell directly anything is available. I believe, so it's already using some sort of, laziness means you may not have to create a lot of things, first of all. The case would be if you, do not have a structural sharing, then say you take an object, you try to change something, so essentially it will create a new object. In that case, the garbage collection would be there. But, there were some, numbers on the garbage collection which showed is very less. There should be some reference within the. Yeah. I think so. Not really, but that would also depend on the implementation, I believe. So, right. So I mean, just because of language. Unless your implementation is good, that will also be a factor. Yeah, but that may not be 100% accurate, but yeah, that's, I'm not sure of it. Yeah, in terms of maturity, I think it's already there for a few years and been slowly evolving, and I think people are more confidently saying that it's a Haskell implementation on JVM than just saying that, okay, it's influenced by Haskell. So I think, yeah, that. Yeah, mostly it is compatible as of now, so that should be possible. I'm not sure, so I mean, I haven't focused on that. So this page should list that differences. I'm sure that gap has reduced over a period of time. So that's, and there are some additional things if you have, so instead of saying, is it length or length? So, in a way, this type of dot notation is supported here. Thinking about more of ID, auto suggestions, etc. This one, like this. What? Start and end. I'm not sure. So making it more lispy. Yeah. So I think there is already a plugin for Eclipse right now, and there is a feature request on IntelliJ which has been recently accepted. So maybe an year back or so, there may be 10 or 20 people might have voted for that. Now it's crossed 100 and. So I mean, in terms of the one limit I would see is there, you can have only 65k methods per class. So if you know, this auto generating stuff is adding more to that, then that could be a problem. But I mean, the same problem exists in Android also, and they use ProGuard. ProGuard, you can use where some of the functions can be inlined, and also I'm not sure of the complete feasibility because it's lazy and all, but that's one option to make it feasible even after that 65 kilobit. Well, so essentially I want to end with saying that by sacrificing some of the perceived conveniences like mutability and all, we are able to explore the whole new world, which can lead to a lot of innovation. And with the JVM being a proven target, so you can always have the convenience of programming in the tool you want and finally run it on your preferred platform. So that's all what I had for today. Thank you. It was a pleasant time.